Hi everyone, I'm so excited for today's video because I got my package from Lisa Eldridge. Now, if you are a fan of Lisa, we all know that she released something new over the past week, last week, and I got myself some goodies from her. Now, unfortunately, I wasn't able to get some of her new lipstick releases because I fell asleep when it was launched, because when she launched, you know, just with the difference in the time, it's actually 11 p.m. here in my country. So by the time I woke up the next day, all of her, well, not all, but she launched four new lipsticks, Velvet Cinnabar, Velvet Petal, Velvet Blush Lightly, and Intrigue. Now, of all the four new Velvet lipsticks that I mentioned, only one was actually still available when I woke up, and it was Velvet Intrigue. Now, so I got myself that. Maddie, are you okay? All right. And I also got myself a number of lip liners from her collection, because she actually made it permanent, which was a nice surprise for me, because I remember when she launched her lip liners back in the day, I was like, oh, I hope it was going to be permanent, because it would be a nice match to her lipsticks. And I wanted to get a lot of lip liners, you know, in various colors, but I stopped myself because I have just recently purchased the Lippy Stash from ColourPop, so I have a ton of lip liners with me at the moment. So I just chose some of the lip liners here based on some of the lip velvets that I have, and I'm gonna discuss that a little bit later down the line in the video. But what I want to talk about first is something that I was very excited about, and it was actually her foundation sample cards, which I was so excited to try. And I'm glad that it's actually bright and sunny today and I'm not using any artificial light, because that's just the best way to actually find the right shade of foundation. Now, what I have here are sample cards, and we have like four blister packs here of foundation. Now, when you purchase anything from Lisa during her launch, you actually get one sample card for free, and you can actually purchase another sample card for around £2. So I decided to purchase an extra sample card just to know, just to have a little bit of diversity here in front of me, and also it just, you know, helps me to find my correct shade from her foundation line. Now I am very excited with her foundation line, because it comes out in 40 different shades, and that is very, like, you know, inclusive. I really have high hopes for it, because, like, you know, Lisa has an eye for color. She has an amazing eye for color, and, you know, sometimes, like, even if I am a makeup artist, I even have trouble finding the right foundation. And I am hoping that, you know, with her release of her foundation line, it's just gonna simplify the process for me. Like, you know, if you take a look at her website, and if you have been wondering how they look like, just peruse through it, you can see there are different shades that caters to different skin tones, so different undertones, to people of different age groups, like, you know, ethnic types. It's so inclusive, so do check that out. So when you get her sample card, there's actually a QR code here at the back that you actually scan, and you get rerouted to her website, and you get, like, you get to see her video explaining on how to find the correct match with your sample card. Now, it's actually a very easy step-by-step process that you can follow. It's also very easy to understand. And again, I don't think that video is available at the moment in her YouTube channel, but I'm sure, like, after the launch of her sample cards, that video will be available on YouTube. But for the moment, I think only people who purchase her sample card has an access to that. Now, Lisa's foundation is simply called The Foundation, and according to the description here, it is intelligently formulated. Self-setting foundation blends effortlessly to smooth and unify skin with a natural-looking, soft focus finish. The skin-friendly formula gives customizable medium coverage that fuses seamlessly with your skin. Start with a little and build to your desired level of enhanced perfection. So I was actually a little bit intrigued by her intelligently formulated self-setting foundation, and I went through her webpage to check that out, and the key ingredients are Oxygeskin. So it's derived from a plant, and it is supposed to have some technology in it that boosts oxygen levels in the skin to ensure a healthy glow day after day. And it also helps to strengthen the skin barrier, and it also boosts hydration to smooth the skin. That's amazing. And there's also Uji tea extract, so that's green tea extract, so that's an antioxidant. And there's also Filmexcel, which is a biopolymer that she discussed in her enlivening, not enlivening blush, in her elevated glow highlighter, where it has some skin tightening capability. So that's great. So I think this foundation will offer some lifting and some tightening. So I guess that's why it's also smoothing. And it also has bamboo stem extract, which says it is highly rich in silica. So that's the one that will give us this nice, soft, focused look. And it helps to absorb any excess perspiration and sebum to give a fresh, soft finish without drying the skin. Wow, that's amazing. It sounds great. Now, I'm not gonna go through every single ingredient list here because I actually want to wait for Lisa to release her own descriptive video for her foundation release. But you know, this is a very interesting foundation to try. And also, it is said here that her foundation is fragrance-free, alcohol-free, and talc-free. That sounds like good news to everyone who has some sensitivity to these types of ingredients. Okay, so let's try her foundation. So I have here two different types of sample cards. One is a light medium sample card in set number two, and I also have one in medium set number one. It's a little bit tricky for me to find my foundation at this time because I have a little of a tan going on. And of course, as you guys have noticed right now, my face is actually a little bit deeper than my neck. And also, there are some things that I have to consider, like the shade of my beard and some discoloration, yada yada. But I'm gonna try to match her foundation to my neck. And let's see if I could find my actual match. Now, before I swatch the colors on my cheeks, I just want to say that the four colors on the sample card here have different undertones. Now, if you go to her website and if you're just very interested to find your shade, it's going to be described there what color and what undertone the foundation has that you're looking at. So, for example, one of the foundation here looks to have an olive undertone. It looks like it has a very nice yellow golden undertone. One has a very beigey ro rosy undertone, and one has a very nice neutral golden undertone. So those types of descriptions is going to be stated under each sample card so that it's going to be easy for you to check that out. And there's also an accompanying photograph for you so that you can just have like a visual reference for that specific foundation that you're looking at. Now, just by looking at the sample card, I can have like an idea which color will go very well with me. Like, you know, this foundation here, this is an olive undertone. This is number 16, might go well with me. But because it has an olive undertone, it's just going to emphasize the greenness of my beard. But let's try to see if that will work. If not, I think this foundation number 15, a very neutral golden undertone foundation, might work for me. But you know, let's just play around with it because that's the great thing when you have new foundations with you. You can just, you know, enjoy and discover what's in store. Okay, so I think the light medium sample card is just a little bit too light for my skin tone. So I'm gonna go into the other sample card, the medium shade sample card. Okay, so I have found my shade and I think I am a medium number 17. So let's just try if this will work for my skin because I actually swatched a little bit of it on my neck. And it kind of disappeared. So it has a very nice golden undertone with a little bit of hints of olive in it. So this is so exciting. So I'm just gonna scoop out some of the product with my spatula. I'm gonna put it at the back of my hand here, as advised by Lisa. And I'm gonna be using a flat synthetic brush for this. And I'm going to start by applying the color around my nails, and I'm just gonna spread it all over. Guys, I need to stop for a while. As you've noticed, I have just been applying the foundation on this side of my face and I have not applied anything on this side of my face. And I am so happy to say my hairs are standing up on my arm that I found an exact match to my skin tone. Look at that. How amazing is that? It looks like I am not wearing foundation at all. And I really like that because sometimes if I wear foundation, it looks very obvious and I get called out by my friends for wearing makeup. But with this one, it's amazing. And then I'm looking at the mirror right now in front of me and it looks like I'm not wearing anything at all. But as you guys can see, like it's covering, it's evening out my skin tone extremely well. It's removing all of the redness. It's just, neutralizing the redness. And it's just making my skin glow in a very nice, soft, focused look kind of way. Very interesting. Wow. Wow, wow, wow. All right. Let me put on a full face. Okay, so that's my foundation down. And I'm just going to buff in some more of that foundation and blend it in with this Yachio brush. Okay, and I'm just picking up some of that foundation and I'm gonna use it just to cover some of my spots and blemishes. And it's actually doing a very good job. Oh my god, wow, look at this. Isn't this amazing? Hang on, I want to try something else. So I actually want to layer a different color and I would like to use the foundation color in number 16, which is a light medium with which is a light medium with olive undertones. And I'm gonna use that in my under eye area, on the bridge of my nose, just some sort of as a highlight. Alright, so this is how Lisa Eldridge's The Seamless Skin Foundation looks on my face. Look at that. It has a very nice soft focus effect. It's not overly dewy, but it's quite luminous. But it's very even. My skin tone is even. I don't really find it necessary to cover my beard area. But if you just look from my cheeks above, this is quite a very nice foundation. Very beautiful. I love it. Now, I can feel it setting on my skin. I feel a little bit of some tightening going on, and I think maybe that's from the Film XL, but it's not overly tightening. Some of those self-setting foundations where you just feel it, suck the hydration from the skin. No, it's not like that. This is very, this is a much more comfortable setting down of the foundation. Wow. Look at that. Look at that. It's very pretty. Now, I did apply a good amount of coverage on my skin. And I'm so happy to say that it's not even caking at all. And it's not emphasizing my lines. So it's very, very natural looking. Very pretty. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to give some time to foundation to fully set on the face. And what we're going to do now is we're going to swatch the lip liners and one of the new lipsticks, the one that's called Velvet Intrigue. So Velvet Intrigue is one of her new lipsticks from her True Velvet lip color collection. And it has a very nice beigey rosy tone that I really, really like. And this is the lightest lipstick in her True Velvet collection. So I'm happy to have this. Now, the main reason why I was very intrigued with Velvet Intrigue is because sometimes when you have very light nude beigey lipsticks, they have more white pigments in it, and sometimes when you wear a lipstick like that, it kind of makes you look sick. But with this one, I don't think so, because this has a much more it has some peachiness to it, so it has a little bit of warmth that will give some life to the lips. So as you can see, I'm just applying the lipstick with the lip brush, and it's actually applying a good amount of color and coverage into my lips. And it's evening out my lip color extremely well. And it's giving a very nice retro vibe without that white pigment. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to apply the lip liner in Intrigue as well. And I'm just going to outline my lips. And this is actually the first time that I'm using Lisa's lip pencils, because the first time it came out, I wasn't able to get it. And I have to say, it's very easy to apply and it's very easy to handle. The color is a little bit deeper than the actual lip velvet, which is great, so it really enhances your lip shape. Okay, so this is how Velvet Intrigue and Velvet Intrigue in Enhance and Define Lip Pencil looks on me. It's giving me that very nice 60s vibe, very, very pretty, and I love that it's actually quite rosy, and there isn't a lot of white pigments in it, and it's actually enhancing my skin. It's just, aside from the fact that her foundation on my skin right now is enhancing my skin extremely well, but this lipstick is just it's just like making my skin look extremely it looks like it smells so good. I have to say that's the perfect description that I can give it. And the lip pencil, I can feel that it has set on my lips. I felt it tighten a little bit, but it's not uncomfortable. And I love the color, although it's a tad deeper than the actual True Velvet in Intrigue. It's a perfect match, and it does a good job of actually defining and enhancing my lips. This is amazing. I love this lip color. I'm so glad that this was still available when I woke up. It's just so sad that the other colors like Velvet Cinnabar, Velvet Blush Lightly, and Velvet Petal all ran out, because they were very beautiful colors, and they were extremely wearable. But I'm happy to say that if you're someone who likes to wear lighter shades of lipsticks, this Velvet Intrigue is very, very good. Okay, so what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to do some arm swatches of the other lip liners with their accompanying lipstick. Okay, so of course, I would like to arm swatch the True Velvet in Intrigue. And this is how it looks like right beside the swatch for the lip pencil, also in Intrigue. Okay, so now I'm going to swatch the color Velvet Beauty. A very nice, lovely color. And also right beside it, I'm gonna swatch the color Beauty in the lip pencil. Okay, next I'm gonna swatch the very vibrant color Velvet Carnival. Love this shade, very beautiful. And now I'm gonna swatch the lip pencil in Carnival right beside it. And last but not the least, I have the True Velvet in Velvet Midnight. I love this color, I have to say. And I'm just going to swatch the lip pencil right beside that, also in Midnight. So I think we can gauge right now that the lip liners are just a tad deeper than the colors of the True Velvets, which isn't so bad because it does the job of enhancing the lips extremely well. Alright, so what I've done right now is I've actually changed my lip look. And what I did is that I actually applied some lip liner in Beauty around the perimeters of my lips. And I just blended it out a little bit. And I added some Gloss Embrace in Muse just so that we have a much more natural, blushing looking lip, and it looks extremely pretty. Especially if, I'm pairing it with the foundation at the moment. All right, so my final thoughts on the foundation is that it has set down extremely well on my skin. It has delivered a very nice, even coverage on my skin, and it hasn't oxidized, which I truly appreciate. And it doesn't feel heavy. I can still move my face because sometimes there are foundations out there that you can feel it on your skin, especially when you start moving and when you show emotion. And that's also one thing that I have to look at when I am buying foundations, because there are actresses who I work with who are very particular with the foundation, and they always tell me, I think the foundation is too thick, I think the foundation is too drying because I can't feel my face move. So that's one thing that I always think when I buy a new foundation, how it feels on the skin. And with this foundation, when you move, when you create emotions, it's actually very comfortable, and you can, there's a certain elasticity to it that I actually love. And also one thing that I have to say is that the color hasn't changed. Because it's cloudy today, so the sun is coming in and out of the clouds, and it doesn't alter. The foundation doesn't alter its color when the lighting changes, so it's very, very color true. That's one of the most important things that I adore about this foundation. All right, so I'm actually looking forward to Lisa's release for the foundation. I'm sure that's coming out anytime soon, so I'm going to be looking forward to that. And I love the new Velvet Intrigue lipstick. Very beautiful. I love a nice 60s vibe to a lip. Very pretty. And I'm so glad that I was able to experience this foundation at this earliest stage. And I do appreciate that Lisa actually released sample cards, because it's just a nice way of getting to know foundations, getting to know formulas without buying a full bottle and not knowing how it looks and appears on the skin. So I really, really truly appreciate that. So that's it for me today. I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. If you have any questions about the products that I use today, please leave them down at the comments box, and let's have a conversation about it. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for being here. I hope that you're having a good day wherever you are. Bye. Congratulations, Lisa. Before, come here. Stay in front of me. Stay in front of me. Come on. What can you say about the foundation? I'm wearing makeup.
You're not wearing
makeup. It's so natural, no? Very nice. I'm wearing makeup.
Is that Lisa's?
Yeah, it's Lisa's.
Okay.
Pretty? Do you approve? He's a film director, he approves.